Welcome to r/ProRevenge. This is a story of someone getting back at someone with ProRevenge after being wronged. Thank you so much for subscribing, likes, and supporting in the comments. And today's first story is Try to Take Away Job, Quit in Glory. This is the story of my wife getting ProRevenge. At 7 months pregnant, we knew my wife wasn't going to return to work after maternity leave, but she had planned on working right to the day her water broke. A few months before her due date, there was a restructuring of the organization. She actually got a promotion and a small raise. But her new direct manager was at the corporate level and had never treated my wife with respect in her previous role. Over the next few months, as my wife started a very major project, she kept detailed notes of everything to make sure that there was a smooth transition when she went out on leave. At this same time, her new boss started being excessive with micromanaging. It finally got to the point that the director, we'll call Patrice, because GD Patrice, started slowly pulling responsibilities away from my wife. To us, it looked like she was trying to position my wife's role to be eliminated when she was on leave. By law, they only had to have a comparable role when she came back, not the exact same position. It finally reached a head when Patrice called my wife into HR to formally reprimand her. Allegations included bad attitude, unprofessional conduct, and outright lying to coworkers. After talking it over, my wife and I decided to say F them, and she gave her 1 week notice the next day. SH hit the fan, and there was a lot of questions, especially from coworkers and management above Patrice. My wife just said that with her upcoming leave, she felt it best to exit now. Then there was the transition meeting. She called in Patrice, her coworkers, her leadership, and the vendor that was involved in the project. During that meeting, my wife went through all the project plans to date with a very specific timeline of the project. This timeline included things like notes from previous meetings of what was stated, validation emails from Patrice, requests for meetings to which Patrice declined or simply no-showed. There was the introduction of the new processes that Patrice put into place, which proved to drastically delay many checkpoints. My wife told me that after the showing the third example of late delivery due to Patrice's lack of response or sudden need to include her friends in the project for feedback, it was apparent to everyone in the room that Patrice was the reason that everything was running behind schedule and over cost. The last slide my wife presented was the last update, the official complaints Patrice had filed with HR, with refuting evidence. My wife told me that Patrice was equally furious and embarrassed, and leadership decided to pull the project from her. My wife left her contact info and let them know she would be available for consulting at competitive rates, finished her 1 week notice, and left. The second story is, apparently, a full shoulder dislocation is muscles you haven't used before. The tale of a company of a-holes and the bee's revenge. So, I'm working in a metal manufacturing plant that fabricated appliance faces, washing machines, dryers, etc., and shelving for fridges and other such things. I enjoyed my job as it was pretty laid back. Granted, I was hired on just before Thanksgiving of 2003, just after my daughter was born. There was a strike going on, and I had become a replacement worker. Normally, I don't like crossing union strike lines, but not all of them walked out to strike, and I had a daughter that was born in July, and I needed the money desperately. I was working the welding machine forever, making the shelving frames and packing them in crates to go to the paint department for a powder coat. One day, however, the machine that cut the rod stopped working, and we couldn't get it going again, and the engineers said it'd be a week for two parts, so I hopped over to the 12-ton stamping machine and started helping out. We moved dies in and out with a forklift, and then we have to bolt them in. It was rather high up, so we had a staircase-style ladder on wheels. The wheels would retract when you outweighed on the steps. At least, they were supposed to. We had warned our supervisors that they needed to fix these D-things, because the wheels would randomly pop back out. They said they did, and had it re-tagged as safe. My A. I was up there one night tightening the top bolts on the open die when they popped. I went over the rail, and the thing went the opposite way. I pretty much performed a half gainer and fell into the open die, bounced off with my right shoulder, and fell 9 feet to the floor on the same shoulder. I laid there in some scrap pieces and oil for about 10 minutes, while my partner and friend Shields came over to help me. He helped me up, and then stepped back saying, OF. Slowly the pain crept in. I turned my head and looked, and my shoulder was fully separated and pushing in the front. I walked over to the supervisor with my partner and told him what happened. He looked at my shoulder and pushed on it and said, it's just muscles you haven't used before. Shields responded with, what the F? Me? I was more tactful. You bald-headed idiot. Did the radiation from the sun scorch your brain, or was it the fumes in the paint department getting to you again? I need to go to the hospital. He relented and said okay, but he docked me a point like an a-hole, and I had to drive myself, in an effing manual car. That was fun. Hours later, they managed to reduce me and gave me a lot of painkillers and muscle relaxers. I went in the next day before my shift and talked to HR. My arm was in a sling. They set me up with a company doctor and then sent me home. The next day I seen the doctor, and he did several tests, reviewed the x-rays and scheduled an MRI. He also refilled my medicine. He wanted me off work until the MRI results, and they agreed. After the results, we did physical therapy, which didn't help. My shoulder kept subluxing, coming out of socket and slamming back in, or dislocating fully. Finally, I got a call from work, and they wanted me to come in. The doctor approved me for light duty. This is where it gets fun. I'm in a sling. I'm really jacked up on narcotics. They want me to inspect the running machines, and then sweep and clean them without shutting them off. I explained that I could do it if they were off, but I'm not comfortable around moving and active machines, because I'm not really aware, because I'm honestly high as SH on these painkillers. They said, well, we're not going to pay you while you're sitting at home playing up your injury. I asked them if they seen the doctor's results. No, of course not. So they should trust their company doctor in HR. So they set me to sweeping, which isn't a big deal as it was a giant open area, but eventually that ran out. I started getting everyone's paperwork for them and filling them out and helping with QA and measuring the parts to make sure they were in spec. It was going good, too good. So they took a bar stool and sat me in an open area where the manager's desks were. They didn't let me have a desk. They didn't let me do paperwork. They wouldn't let me bring a book or anything to write on. My original supervisor was fired at some point for something not related to anything really. So I had the original supervisor that hired me. He was an A. I seriously got up and went to pee and he yelled and carried on like an A. I asked him if he was done and he got red-faced. I asked him why he had me sitting here doing nothing and he said, well, you're so hurt, boo-hoo. So the next day I brought in a dunce cap I made and a little sign that said I was being punished for being injured. I talked to HR, whom said they couldn't do anything about it, even though I had other odds and ends I could do that was beneficial and helped the company out. I asked if it was really necessary to sit me on a bar stool like I was in timeout when I was 25 years old because I got injured due to their crappy ladder that they lied about. She said that they couldn't pay for me to sit at home. So I wore the dunce cap and held the sign all night. The entire time I was going through the doctor's visits and gearing up for a surgery, and it was looking like I was going to be out for a while. We're about 3 weeks into this SH at this point. I end up being told to go and sort parts by the a-hole supervisor. The parts were coming off of a conveyor near a stamping machine and needed two hands to move. He told me to make do or I'm fired. So I go over there peeved off, and 5 hours into it, I'm sore as heck from doing this left-handed, and I'm getting beat at because I'm slow. Then it happens. I effing pull muscles in my left arm, back and neck, from being a dumb A and not standing up for myself. He curses me up one side and down the other and just takes me to the ER and drops me off. They see me and confirmed and gave me the paperwork. I thought he was waiting in the parking lot, but he actually left. I had to call my mother to come get me, and I was really effed up from all the pain shots. The next day I call into HR, and they fire me because I had pointed out and I was on drugs. I had never missed a shift save from the doctor's appointments, going to the ER and physical therapy. Even then, I went in right after my appointments. I was peeved. Yup, definitely peeved off. I go to my next scheduled doctor's appointment, and he gives me my date for surgery. I go through the surgery, recover and do physical therapy, while gathering all of my paperwork and preparing to take this to a lawyer. I'm finally cleared and declared healed. Then it happens. One day I'm getting up off the couch. My little girl is cradled in my left arm, and I push off with my just healed right. Nothing too bad or strenuous. It blows out the back this time. I fell and cracked my head on our entertainment center, bleeding and cursing like heck. It was either take the bumps or land on my daughter. ER visit again, and they reduce it and say that it looks like I may have some muscle damage from what just happened. All the subluxes isn't what originally happened. I tell the company doctor at the next visit, and he not only tells me that that isn't true, but that I'm taking advantage of him. He took the sling off and threw it in the garbage can and says there's nothing more he can do for me. The next day, wearing a new sling, my mother walks me into one of the most vicious lawyers in the city. 2 days later, I'm seeing a new doctor and getting all sorts of tests. They inject dye with a huge needle that they scraped across the bone, and guh, I do not recommend it. They say there's so much damage that I need another immediate surgery because I'm omnidirectional, and the first doctor should have been able to see it. As my new one is looking at my old results, he shows me on the MRIs where he can tell how it was apparent in the beginning. Translation: the company doctor half-aided my first surgery. The company is trying to fight me on this, but eventually they relented, and I get my surgery. I've 3 anchors in my right shoulder holding me together. I have to now go to checkups every 6 months, even years later, and I'm now looking at another surgery because there's nerve damage. My lawyer finishes up with them, and I won a several thousand, into the six-figure area, dollar lawsuit from not only the company but the doctor as well. Not 5 months after, the company announced they were bankrupt and were closing their doors. The SH supervisor tried to get a job at another factory, where my friend was well respected and he knew what was going on. The guy didn't get the job, and we all ran into him last year, He was working fast food. I'd like to think that I had a hand in the company's demise. It would have been good if they had just taken care of me. I wouldn't have sued if they didn't F me over and try to get me to quit through embarrassment. For clarification, yes, I know that crossing a strike line wasn't smart, but there were not a lot of decent paying jobs in the area with the favorable hours at the time. I had a newborn that needed a lot of attention due to being under the lights with a temperature check every hour and force feeding her every two. My girlfriend couldn't do all the time as the lack of sleep was catching up to her and making her postpartum worse. I did what I had to do to help my family at the time, and I learned a valuable if painful lesson. I know it's not a juicy, satisfying revenge to most, but I'm ultimately content with the outcome of them having to pay up, my medical bills covered and going back to college, all while my daughter is well taken care of. And the last story is, I don't work there anymore. I posted this in malicious compliance, but it was suggested that it belonged here. My employer decided to convert all of a certain class of our records from paper-based files to digital. There were three immediate problems. Our company was not going to buy a generic system, but develop our own unique tailored system. It was to be done on the cheap, with net savings for record keeping from year one. The guy in charge, let's call him Genius, always, and I mean always, thought he was the smartest guy in the room. Believe me, he wasn't. Anyway, one of the girls I worked with took on the project, on the condition that she could have the next July off for her wedding and honeymoon. She worked hard, and the project was actually making progress. One of her duties was passwords, none of which could be written anywhere, because Genius knew this was bad. She periodically reminded Genius about the July wedding, and he told her it'd be fine, but never signed off the paperwork. Come mid-May, the project is way behind, mainly because Genius told management it could all be done in-house at negligible cost. And Genius kept changing the design every time he read a new magazine article on IT. My friend was then told 6 weeks out from the wedding that her leave was canceled. The project took priority, and she just have to reschedule her wedding, honeymoon, the works. Genius just could not see that this might be a problem. So she did her job, updated the passwords as required, never recording them anywhere, as required, and resigned without notice the last day of June. On her honeymoon, she gets a frantic call from Genius, demanding all the passwords. Sorry, I don't work there anymore. Click. That's why a decade later, our company still has a few hundred electronic case files we can't access. Thank you, friends, for watching the video to the end, and if you liked it, don't forget to subscribe. Have a good day!